Hey everybody, it's Victa. It's time to continue Eden Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you everybody for the support on the Eden Streak as well as the like streak, which is holding at 8 right now because it's not been 24 hours since the last video was recorded. That one sitting yesterday around 1,408 some odd likes at the time of this recording, but I think that we're probably going to make it because we have not missed a 1,700 like streak goal yet. Yeah. And again, about the meme of the day, we're still on the fence about what we're going to do with the meme of the day so far anyway. C-Day is going to be X-Ray Zulu 9 November 7 Hotel 9 Frank. Now, talking about meme of the day, our damage is just horrible. I think we have Jar of Flies, though. We also have the Locust of Death and Sack of Sacks. No, that's a... what is that? It's the Locust of Pestilence, I think. Yeah, we do have Jar of Flies, thank goodness, so... Yeah, not a terrible start, but not a great start either. We just need to be careful with our HP and hope for the best as far as damage upgrades are concerned. Now, again, speaking about the meme of the day for a little bit here, a lot of the prevailing feedback I've been getting recently seems to be more in favor of, it was fun for a while, but I think we're all over it by now. And especially if we have to start spending some time, I'm paraphrasing here, essentially, the prevailing feedback is that. It is like, it was fun for a while, but I think everyone's kind of over it by now. Some people on YouTube said that they wouldn't mind seeing it go away. Not that it was terrible or anything, it's just not unnecessary. Especially if we have to now spend some more time into reviewing art and stuff. Some other people suggested that we can only post art that has a watermark on it, and I think it's... While yes, it is true, I want to make sure that people get proper credit. As we talked about a couple days ago, I think that it's one of those things that's most likely going to be just sort of be like, yeah, it was a great era. But we'll see. We'll see. I, for one, wouldn't mind keeping the meme of the day stuff going, but it certainly is not... It's not worth... getting people upset or have in fear of having art stolen or anything like that. It was just supposed to be a fun little thing. Same thing goes for the like streak, really. The like streak was not supposed to be a huge, grandiose, we got to do a bigger, grander giveaway for all the crazier numbers that we hit. Well, I do think that is good for sure, having incentive like that. That's not how it was meant to be. That's my problem, is that my problem is, like, I'll start out with something small, and then we hit some sort of accomplishment, and then I'm like, well, I have to do something bigger now, because, how do you match that? We can't just give away the same thing over and over again, sort of thing, so. And most people would probably agree that most people are like, we don't really need anything back from you, but some other people surprisingly do feel that, If we give an inch, they take a mile, sort of a thing, So that's always kind of been a problem with me. But I've also really liked interacting and giving stuff away. So yeah. We have successfully found every dead end here. Welcome everyone. We've arrived. Very happy to see SMB Superfan. Of course, that is going to be one of the true all stat upgrades in the game, and I'm very happy to have that. It's going to be a great help here. Not going to take doorstop. Jar of Flies is going to spawn a fly inside of our jar every time we kill an enemy with our tears. Assuming that they don't... assuming they don't get killed by one of our flies, they will spawn us another fly. As simple as that. Of course, the flies do deal 1.5 times damage. Spiders deal 200% damage of your base damage. And get ready to see this room for quite a while. And I'm actually really sad now. This is the reason why you don't take soul hearts. This is the reason why you do not take soul hearts until after you are done clearing the room or clearing the floor, because you do not want to sacrifice the possibility of you getting a devil deal by taking dumb damage or bad damage against a boss and then leaving yourself with no soul hearts. You protected yourself from dying on this floor, but unless if you're in dire need of doing that, Most likely, it's always best to just play it safe, and you want to preserve the soul hearts as much as possible. And this is two runs in a row now we've gotten Champion Ragman. This is the worst Champion Ragman, by the way. Hopefully for painfully obvious reasons, but if you don't know why, it's because Orange Ragman spawns more adds than usual, and also that means that he heals more, meaning that there's more stuff that you have to dodge. There's just more opportunities for you to take damage, and... He's quite awful. By far, the worst iteration of Fragman, by far. So, Jarfly is helping us out a little bit. Luckily, we didn't take... For all that doomsaying, we actually didn't take any damage, and we get a great damage upgrade here in Pentagram. Not a bad start now.
Nice world card, loser! Have another curse of loss, nerd!
Once again, we are here with not really a great idea of where we're supposed to be going. But we've got ourselves a little bit of protection. I'm hoping Sack of Sacks drops more than just simply full charges. I mean, full charges is the name of the game when it comes to Sack of Sacks, but I wouldn't mind getting like a key or a bomb every now and then, or a soul heart or tarot card or really anything. I know where the secret room and super secret room are. When you finally get a key from one of the sacks, it's good. Pentagrams is just going to give us a straight up damage upgrade. Wanted to make sure the champions do not get close to us here. Okay, so we have a bomb. The regular secret room I know for an absolute 100% certainty is right here. 100%. And super secret room is to the west of that room up there that we were just in before the boss room. Yeah, so you see there, if you notice that our fly count did not go up at all in this room, it's because all of the deaths that we caused were caused by our flies, and enemies killed by your flies will not spawn more flies. As cool as that would be completely broken and overpowered. We don't want that. I mean, it's good to be OP every now and then, but you know, when you're OP on every single run, then there's just no fun. No fun in a one run, if it's every run. A little bit of a lag there on the video. That wasn't you. That wasn't you. That was not your internet connection. That was my computer just freaking out as usual. I feel like I'm in such a holding pattern right now, money-wise, because everything. Apparently, we got shot by the world's fastest demon fire. Everything that like I want to get, or I usually go like right now, I'd be if I wasn't saying for the house, I would be like saying like, yeah, I'm looking for a new computer, you know, looking to see what kind of replacements I can do because I'm done building computers. I've already talked about that. I'm just flat out done. I'm over it. I'd rather hold someone else responsible other than myself, because at this point I'm too busy to even work. And make, or not work, but to create a new computer, you know. I still could, but I've done it for so long now. I just don't want to anymore. I'd rather just get a professionally built machine, someone I can hold accountable if something goes wrong, that sort of stuff. The minor stuff that goes wrong, I mean, obviously I'll be able to fix it myself, but yeah. Doing something that you normally would not want to do here, and that's cap out on your flies. I don't recommend doing that unless if you're about to go fight the boss. Okay, I thought it's the super secret room was either going to be right there where I just got done bombing, or to the room before the room of before the boss, and I'll show you where that is, because I'm almost 100. I'm actually 100% sure now where it is. It's gonna be to the left of this room right there. It could be north of here, but I'm pretty sure it's to the left of that other one. Got ourselves Limehorn. We want to make sure that we consume our flies now on Limehorn and Linehorn. Limehorn. You know what I mean. Get the nail. The nail is going to be better than Jar of Flies, and we'll head on down. Wow, we can see the map. Oh, man. Like a new game. But anyway, the point is, like, there's some things I would like to spend money on right now, and I feel like I can't. I mean, I could for sure, but I'm so engrossed in the idea of saving up for the house that, like, I feel like I just need every cent I can just to hold on to right now. You know, I can't really enjoy the money that I make. Not that I spend super frivolously or anything, but you know, I would like to replace my hard drives because one of them is definitely going out. I'd like to get a couple of things for the car. I definitely want to get my car redone. She's an old car, but still works pretty well. Car I've had since forever. I had my driver's license. It's like 900 years ago. I need to get I've been wanting to get a surgical procedure done on my sinuses to help out with my allergy issues. Okay, I always have sinus issues every single year, pretty much every single day of every single year. And they do a procedure called a balloon rhinoplasty, sinusplasty, something like that. I think rhinoplasty is an actual new nose. A sinusplasty is what I'm thinking of. Anyway, there's some specialist doctors in the city that pioneered this particular treatment. It's supposed to be non-invasive, no scars or anything. And it's supposed to take, they can just do it in the office. So that's pretty cool. And like the average cost is like three, like with insurance, which I do have now, with health insurance, it's like it's anywhere from $1,000 to $3,000 or something like that. It's like, man, I'd love to, but, but everything's got to go to the down payment. I guess that's what they call being a grown-up. You know, when I was a kid, I didn't even know what a down payment was, man. None of that made sense to me. I was like, I have a house. I don't know where it comes from. I just have a house. that's it. Like money. I was like, I don't know where this money comes from, but my parents, they pay for everything. You know, you never realize how ignorant you are as a child until you get to an adult. It's like, oh, yeah. Kids cost money. They cost lots of money. How did my parents do this? You know? And if they have more than one kid, it's like, how in the world did they do this? That's the scary thing about new media, man. Is the, and not everyone likes to talk about money. I don't mind talking about money. I don't like talking about my own money, but I don't mind discussing money from like a business standpoint. Rotten Babe's gonna be excellent here. Hopefully we get Hive Mind. Oh my goodness. Don't mind if I do. Guppy's Paw is gonna be a free Guppy item there and give us 3 soul hearts as well for one of our red heart containers. But yeah, that's like one thing that I don't mind talking about. I don't like talking about my money in particular. But I don't mind talking about how it works from new media standpoint. And the scary thing about this industry is that there's no union, there's no fallback plan, there's no severance pay, nothing like that. We are completely at the mercy of whatever we're dealt. You know, that's why it's so difficult. It is so difficult to make it in this industry in particular. And even if you do, which I am not ready to say that I've made it yet. For me, the prerequisite for me saying that I've made it is when I have a house of my own, and it is completely funded and paid off by me doing this. Then I will begrudgingly say I can say that I've made it now. I should have bought. The reason, if you're wondering why I didn't buy blank card, is because right now the nail makes more sense. But blank card hero font is a GG because it is impossible for us to die. Especially if we get something like tarot cloth or we get car battery, it is not possible for us to die. So we really need to get some money here. Pageant Boy would be amazing, but we're not going to get Pageant Boy. We better not get Pageant Boy from the Fallen. That's just a big old FU. Good dodges there. That was not a good dodge. No deal with the devil. Okay, so we've got 3 bombs and we don't know. There could be an arcade. Every cent helps. Every cent helps for sure. We've already did the mob trap room. I think there was a nickel eye keeper inside the secret room. I think there was, and I think I bombed it already. Good check. I'm not gonna use a bomb here because these bombs might be our only salvation. No, but it's worth. Not worth trying. Tenant Rock is definitely worth trying here, just for the chance to get a small rock or anything. Soul Heart's fine. We may not be able to get blank card here. I should have at least bought blank card. But it's easy to go hindsight on that one, because like we had no idea that was going to be a Hierophant card, you know. And I was more concerned at the current situation, which was making sure that we have enough HP to not die to the boss or anything like that. And of course, we weren't in that much danger, but I like to shore up our defenses. So we have two bombs to get 12 cents, which is just not going to happen. Yeah, it's not going to happen. The correct play here was for us to take blank card, obviously. But again, hindsight withstanding, there's not very much. I mean, just because we see blank card doesn't mean that we won't see it again. The Valiant Effort donation machine, Valiant Effort. It's all right. I mean, us not getting blank card, it's not the worst thing in the world. We should have definitely gotten it. And you can definitely argue that I shouldn't have bought that Soul Heart, but again, hindsight's 20/20. All right, I sneeze real quick. That's another thing. I think a lot of people in the comments for like yesterday were saying like, "Oh, you should have waited to Diplopia to see if you got Steam Sale. Then you could have done it." But yeah, it's easy to say that. But you got to remember that at the time that we didn't like at that point we weren't planning on breaking the game. And you can't really say like, "Well, you should always do this anyway." It's like, well, if you want to play like that, then go for it. If I have an opportunity, if I fight greed and then I'm like, yeah, sure, like we might get Diplopia in the store, or if we find a greed fight inside of a secret room after I've already been to the store, my mind isn't on like, well, I should go back and maybe get a double Steam sale from this. Yes, it's possible, but I don't play like that. To me, that's more of a min-maxy sort of way, and it's wise to be sure. I'm not trying to slight anyone who plays like that. I just don't play like that. I'm not thinking of the long-term game here on that. It's like, yeah, we have Diplopia and we go fight a greed fight, you know, and if greed drops a Steam sale and I have Diplopia, then yeah, of course, unless if it's the final store on the entire run and we're not planning on going to Hush, then yeah, of course I'm going to Diplopia Steam sale. I've done it before. It's just not a play that I actively keep in my memory bank. My mental image memory bank, just because it's not something that like I ever usually have to do. But it's not out of laziness though. It's just out of just common. It's just common for me not to think about that. That's all I can say. So this is a god awful room to be fighting anyone in, especially Mega Fatty. Pretty upset that didn't actually hit him. Took damage on the final shot. An HP upgrade. And we've got interesting items in here. I don't think we take Book of Sin, because the only thing that we're really taking Book of Sin for would be for the consumables. Now, we could, if we really, really wanted to, we could take the Book of Sin just to tap it for Bookworm, but with Maw of the Void and now the Mark, I think that it goes without saying that we're probably sitting ourselves at a one run. I mean, Maw of the Void's fantastic. We've got the nail to shore up any sort of idiotic plays like the one I just did by walking into that fire. And we could still get blank card, too. That's the thing. Ooh. I'm going to go for more options, but... Almost did it again. But the jumper cables are... I mean, the jumper cables are, again, those are one of those, like, safe-to-pick-up items that I like to talk about. They're always a good pickup. There's no reason not to get jumper cables if you have the ability to. Unless something in the shop takes priority, the jumper cables will always be a solid investment. For every 15 kills you get, you're gonna get one full charge. You're gonna get one charge on your spacebar item. And when you combine that with a soul heart generator, like the nail, that's a very powerful amount. That's a very powerful sustainable life source there. And then you can also couple that with the fact that we have Maw of the freaking Void now, so that's gonna be even more HP that we're able to save and recover. We have one Guppy item. There's no reason for us not to, There's no reason for us not to, check every dark chest we get now, especially since we have the hand of, or the left hand. We're probably gonna have to do this again, unless I don't care about Bob's curse, which I kind of don't.
Don't say you ever needed a bomb, Sindicta. Don't complain about not having a bomb. You just left Bob's curse there, Sindicta.
Yeah, well, we just got Guppy's head. What now?
That's conjecture, Sindicta.
It's not. There goes that insane YouTuber, Sindicta, again, talking to himself. How incredibly, like, crazy I must sound and look. To someone who is not familiar with this job, who's like, you know, a fly on the wall for the first time ever. I don't know how my ex-girlfriend has ever put up with it. Maybe that's the reason why they're ex-girlfriends. I don't know. And another curse of lost. In that department, I've been very lucky and fortunate to have dated girlfriends who understood the job. They understood, like, it is not an easy thing to put up with as a significant other. You know, it requires a lot of time of just solo stuff. You know, I'm sitting here. If I'm sitting down here at the computer recording stuff, I can't be spending time with your significant other not your significant other. Look, you know what I mean. I can't spend time with my girlfriend if I'm sitting here working, you know.
Sindicta, you should hold on to that. Maybe you get diplopia, Sindicta.
Oh, there's a double-tinted rock in here. Fascinating. Unfortunately, we only have one bomb, but we do have the nail. So that was a double-tinted rock right there.
I know it's double-tinted rocks, Sindicta.
Well, if you see a rock with an X on it, it means it's a tinted rock. But or with a dark X on it. If you see a rock with a light X on it in the middle, more not located off to the side, but towards the middle, that is a double-tinted rock. Yeah, so this right here, if you see this rock I'm shooting, you see that X, that light rock? That X that's like cockeyed to the right over there? That is a regular tinted rock. The other one is a lighter X inside of, and it's more towards the middle of a bigger stone. Okay, well. There's another tinted rock right in the exact same place as the other one. Got more soul hearts. Yeah, the nail has been doing okay. It's gonna be a dead end here. No. Not until we get Guppy. Okay, it's gonna be another dead end here. All right. And we might as well. It's good to know that I didn't need blank card hero font after all this time. I feel a little bit less derpy now after I've been vindicated of that derp. But no, I've been very lucky and fortunate to have met my last couple of girlfriends. They understand. You know, they're always supportive. That's another thing. Wow, another dead end. Dead end city over here. No, that's one thing I was very thankful for. Not easy. Okay, it's just gonna be another dead end here. All right. Let's try to find that item room, shall we, Isaac? What's down here? The only other way that we've not gone yet. The other secret room's to the left of there, but we don't really care. The curse room. And nowadays, it's like, I can't even imagine having a social life. I mean, I barely sleep, let alone have a social life. Is this really another dead end? It is. Woo! All right, Isaac. Here we go. Here we go. All right, let's just go, I guess, check over here and, at this point, if I find the boss, I know we're going to the boss room. I have no idea where the item room is. I have absolutely no clue. And at this point, I don't really care. Like, we don't need any more items for this run to work. Very happy to get an orbital here, though. Did get a deal with the devil. And we got Guppy. We got the Gupster. A long time coming. How you been, Guppy? And curse the blind. Got another thing coming, Gupper. We are going to get Guppy, of course. Guppy is going to give us the mulligan effect, which is going to spawn a fly every time we hit a offensive shot against the target. Very, very good. That's passive. On top of that, we also get flying. 9 lives wouldn't be too bad as well, but, I mean, it's not something that we need at this point. Again, we have so much. We don't have a whole lot of raw damage that we're doing, but at the same time, we do have a lot of DPS because of the Guppy flies, because of Maw of the Void. And of course, Maw of the Void also acts as a soul heart generator, time to time. More money here. I am gonna bomb the keeper for hopefully a nickel. If for anything else, just to get a little bit of extra money to put back in our donation machine. I mean, we've been dinging our donation machine pretty hard. Gotta be careful with the purple fires. They'll shoot spoonbender tears at you. They'll get you. The blind shop. I don't care about a blind shop. Cool club. Sure, whatever. So we'll put back as much money as we can in the donation machine, then we'll just buy wherever else. Okay. Road detonator. And red candidate. Just because someone's going to say, you didn't destroy the keeper. There you go, Thrall. I did it. That was just for Thrall. All the Thralls out there. People have been asking me with enthusiasm if I'm going to be playing WoW Classic. I've made my characters on the realms, but I don't know if I'm gonna play. The more and more that I think about it, like, I'm still of the same mindset that I've already played Classic WoW once, and I did it for since beta. Right, I was playing back in the time when rogues had bucklers, when they started with shields, you know, back in 2003. And I played WoW for a very, very long time. I loved WoW. I mean, WoW made the channel. Like, without Lauder, we wouldn't have us Invicta. That's how I got my start. I started doing WoW PvP movies. And it was through the skills that I attained to learn how to edit that I eventually became friends with Husky, and then, you know, blah blah blah. We already went through the whole thing this past week. But I have been saying, I had told many friends, I was like, yeah, I'm not planning on. They were asking me, are you playing Classic WoW? Are you playing Classic WoW? I was like, nah. I mean, I've already done it. Like, it's doesn't. I've done it once. I don't see a reason to do it again. But I decided that since they were letting people make characters and reserve names and stuff, I was like, okay, I'm just gonna reserve a name on a server just in case I actually start playing or not. Am I excited about Classic WoW? No. No. There's no hype for me anyway. Again, I've played WoW forever. It doesn't bother me if I don't play on day one or just don't play Classic WoW again. I just wanted to make sure that I had the characters ready to go just in case I decided to start playing again. And I will, I'm not going to lie to you. I will hop on Classic WoW and play a little bit. I don't know how hard I'll go with it, you know. It's certainly not going to harken back to the days of the Lauder days where I'm putting 60 hours a week just on editing alone, you know. Like, I don't anticipate that happening. Definitely going to take Roid Rage here. We need some more movement speed. Oh my goodness. The venerable cornucopia of devil deals here, none of which look all that great. It's a little brimmy. I'll take a little brimstone just for the DPS, but just leave the rest and head on down. But yeah, I mean, I'm gonna play. I don't know how hardcore it will be. I'm gonna be on. Apparently I picked the streamer server because I made Zinvicta, I made Lauder on Feralina. Before like it ever got out that like all the big time WoW streamers are picking that server as well. Had I known that that's where they were going, I would have gone somewhere else. And I guess I still technically can, but I also have other people who are now playing on that server too, so. Who knows? But I will be playing. Am I excited about it? I'm indifferent. Am I, like, super hype? Like, oh, it's gonna take over my life again. No. Not in the least bit. Not at all. I've done it once. No thank you. But it will be neat to go see WoW before it was ruined. Everyone likes to try to recapture the magic of nostalgia of Classic WoW. No deal with the devil again. We'll just keep on going. But, you know, it's fun to revisit old games. In a way, it's a little bit disappointing and kind of depressing as well. It's like going back to like a place where you used to live, right? And you see that there's like someone else living in your old apartment, or like they've changed up the roads or somewhere. You know, like it's not quite perfect the way that you remember it was when you left that place. That's sort of the feeling that I get when I see nostalgic video game stuff. I think a lot of people look at Classic WoW and they're like, oh man, those are the golden days. I'm like, I think a lot of it has to do with people remembering the social connections that they made playing WoW and not the actual game itself, because the game itself was taxing to play. It was very annoying to play at times, especially if you PvP'd. And that's something I did all of the time as a rogue. I started out as a rogue and then ended up as a warrior. But anyway, that's the answer to that question. Excellent Guppy run, though, here. Oh, wow, that is a very odd place for Isaac. You know what? I'll take it. I ain't gonna hate on it. Later on today, we have our Introducing the Inventor episode coming out for Dicey Dungeons. So for those of you who've been looking forward to playing that class, you would definitely should check out that Dicey Dungeons video. People still been asking where Risk of Rain 2 stuff is. It's still always in the works. It's like, do I want to record maybe one Risk of Rain run, or do I want to record like four Dicey Dungeon runs, you know? Yeah, screw it. Let's end it with a bang. Got conjoined. Remember, we still get Guppy. Oh my goodness. Okay, we do not have anti-grav tears. I don't know why the tears are just stopping like that all of a sudden. Okay. It's interesting. Oh. Tiny Planet essentially guarantees that any Mega Troll Bomb spawn near you or are going to follow you. Take Lusty Blood here. I don't know what kind of build we're seeing right now, but all I know is that Guppy is loving it. Judas's freaking shadow. I'm not going to turn into Black Judas, but oh good lord, what is this? That was so much damage from Tech Zero and Tech Point 5. We have Ease Mascara, Compound Fracture. Wow. Our damage is only 4.08, but we're doing that much damage? Holy smokes. Now that is some elite level damage there. Especially with Guppy. And we also have Sissy, of course. Little baby Sissy. Either way, thank you all very much for tuning in. I do appreciate it. I hope you had a great start to your Sunday, everyone. Curse of the Lost in the Void.
What'd you get for trying to do something nice, loser? Enjoy another Curse of the Lost, nerd. Number 3.
I'd like to think I made someone's day by electing to do one more. We'll just do one more. We'll go to Delirium because we have this powerful run. I'm not re-rolling this run. If we're doing Delirium, then this is the build we got. Because this is a very, very powerful run here. And I do not want to jeopardize the streak because we got a really bad D100 roll. The only reason why I'm doing this is because of the strength of this run, of this roll right here. Now, it will be nice if we do get in trouble against Delirium. We have the D100 to roll in case if we need emergency HP, because chances are we are going to get more HP from rerolling. But hopefully we just don't have to worry about that. But, I mean, we're doing so much damage, and remember, we're Guppy. I think this gives us Bookworm. Nope. Okay. We found another dead end here, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. I know I have a lot of choices here in your dead-end pleasures of the world, but we're very excited and happy that you chose us. I love on the subreddit people are posting like, I've been watching Sinvicta so long that I think I've gained his luck now. Ah, yes. The Echoes of the Damned. Welcome. Welcome, my friends. Welcome to the hell that is every day for me. It is certainly Murphy's Law. It's gonna be another dead end here.
How does he do it? How does one person find so many dead ends when he's not trying to? And he can't even see the map to do it purposefully. How does he do it? Hehe, nice compass, nerd!
Infestation 2 is going to be a huge help as well. I don't think we have Hive Mind anymore, but we still do a butt ton of damage. And while it would be nice to be able to see the map, it doesn't really matter. As long as we don't take too much bad damage, we don't have anything to fear from anything in the void here. Our damage is just too high. I'd like to hope I made someone's day. They thought the Isaac video was over, then decided, we'll just do one more. Why not? Why not do one more? And then we get Curse of Losted, but you know, they love you. So we're able to do some pretty good damage here against Isaac. Or against Mom, I should say. It is unfortunate that we don't have Polar Invincibility. Delirium is back. I didn't see that there is an eye laser. Another one here. I think we have an infestation one, maybe? We got a whole lot of flies when we took damage from that last one. Again, if we do get in trouble, we still have the D100 we can use, and that is almost certainly going to give us more HP. There we go. That's where we went delirium. Trailing right behind us, eating all those flies, and then moving at 4 billion miles an hour. I seem to recall the last time we were in this position where I was like, all right, no more delirium. Here we go. Now look at us. Here we are again. Old's Invicta, glutton for punishments, Invicta. He has to make sure that everyone shares the pain. Nah. We got Guppy. We got Little Sissy. There ain't no losing here. Even if we get down to 1 HP, all we got to do is just simply hit the D100. We're fine. That's how it goes. Now just imagine if we had a higher tiers rate. Think about the DPS there, or even like shot speed. Ease Mascara really ruined that one, but low stats anyway. I mean, Ease Mascara made that damage happen. Either way, there we go. Now we can end the run. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully the delirium kill was worth an extra couple of likes out there. Hope you had a great start to your Sunday. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.